Hey everybody, Pastor Jeremy here with two insights for you from my time of Bible study in Acts chapter 7 and 8. If you're not familiar with these two chapters, this is where the deadly persecution breaks out against the church. And it all starts with a guy named Stephen. Stephen was first introduced to us in Acts chapter 6, where he was appointed to attend to the needs of the church's widows. Now, there, he was described as a man full of the Holy Spirit and wisdom. But at the end of that chapter, he was arrested by the Sanhedrin on charges of blasphemy. Now, throughout chapter 7, then, he preaches to these Jewish officials, pointing out that they were the ones that had rejected Moses, they were the ones that had rejected the prophets, they were the ones that had now rejected Jesus. And then, in chapter 7, verses 51 through 53, he brings his message home by calling his audience stiff-necked people with uncircumcised hearts and ears, and accusing them of resisting the Holy Spirit, persecuting and even killing prophets, and murdering the Messiah. Now, you might expect that indictment didn't sit too well with Stephen's listeners. And you'd be right. In verse 54, we read that they were enraged. And by the end of the chapter, they had abandoned all pretense of legitimacy, and they had stoned Stephen to death. Now, here's the thing, though. Stephen had to know that his message would enrage them. He had to know that they would riot and probably even kill him. He had to know that this message would be absolutely unpopular. But he also knew that if he was going to be faithful to Jesus, he had to deliver it. In other words, Stephen was compelled to choose between popularity and faithfulness. And he chose faithfulness. We're in the same situation. When we're faced with that same kind of a choice, we need to do the same thing. Choose faithfulness over popularity every single time. That's your first insight. The second one comes from a little bit later in the aftermath of Stephen's death. The beginning of Acts chapter 8 tells us of the severe persecution that erupted. It scattered all the believers except for the apostles. The apostles are the only ones that stay in Jerusalem. Everybody else runs away. And the thousands of men and women who had placed their faith in Jesus since Pentecost, they ran for their lives, with many of them returning to their homes. In verse 4, then, we read that those who were scattered went on their way preaching the message of good news. Did you hear that? The apostles stayed in Jerusalem, and those who were scattered, that is, all the ordinary Christians running for their lives, they're the ones who began teaching the gospel wherever they went. So many times we think that we can't preach the gospel because we're not an apostle or a professional minister, or something along those lines. Or maybe more accurately, we assume that sharing the good news of Jesus is the job of someone who gets paid to do so. But the fact is, we are all qualified to share the gospel. Moreover, we are all commissioned to tell people the good news about Jesus, wherever we might be, whoever we might find ourselves with. So look around yourself today. Who do you see that needs to hear about Jesus? Now, go share with them. Hey, thanks for listening. That's Acts chapter 7 and 8. We'll check you later. Bye-bye.